seems like when you really start to go on this journey, it's like so much gets exposed and you feel out of your comfort zone and confused and, you know, just turned around. It's just a lot of the ego interpretations of what's happening, even though there's like a loosening in the mind occurring. It's just, it's perceived as a very dark thing, a very frightening thing. It's just symbolic of the divine law that all that you give to yourself, that giving and receiving are the same, as you sow, so shall you reap. We've heard about it, karma, it comes in different names. And that just is the divine law, and it's pretty symbolic of what's going on, because, you know, when you come here, it is kind of getting out of the familiar, out of comfort zones, starting to expose things, emotions are raw. And the past associations was always to shut it off, go hide, just leave. You know, if you visited a group and you went, I don't know what they're all talking about, but it's a little bit too transparent and everyone's a little too open, you just either would leave or you would sit there and be polite, and then when you got out of the door, you know, not going back there again. Hour after hour, day after day, you know, it's like your mind is getting exposed and there's just no quick, easy escape hatch, you know, to just change, you know, move away in proximity or just get away. And, you know, I know I've worked with a lot of people over the years, you know, it's just so clear and straight and direct, but that's oftentimes the reaction. It's like, closer, 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 yipes. Just, they vanish, they're gone. Not Thomas, who was here today. I mean, he would come and go, come and go, come and go. One time he was at the Peace House for a number of months, I think, and he just left with just a little post-it note. Thank you.
He told me about
it. But that's the fear of losing the self, or what will I become if I continue on with this of questioning and loosening and exposing and this preferred self, you know, wow, like I can't even imagine where this is going to even go if I keep emptying and emptying and emptying. So, yeah, it takes a lot. And that's the thing is, you know, with movies like The Secret or manifesting movies and so forth, you know, the big attraction is, you know, create your own universe, you know, create your own reality. Create the world the way you want it, and that's associated with empowerment. And then the deeper you get into spirituality, you start to realize that, well, that's not going to give me peace of mind. But to the ego, that's a tough pill. You know, the ego got into this whole thing with a little bit of improvement in mind. It's okay, all right. Let's do this. It's going to be some hard work, and there are going to be some difficult times, but it will improve things. And then you start to go deeper into, you know, this whole improvement idea, self-improvement and self-help and all that. And then at some point, it's like, oh my gosh, this isn't about improving a self at all. This is about letting go of everything that I've known, or thought I've known, and whatever. And that, you know, brings up a lot of terror, you know, because it's a sense of letting go of the familiar, letting go of the known. Even a sense of misery seems better than complete unknown, you know, which is the way the journey starts to feel more and more like, you know, what's going to be left of me? You know, will I be like the scarecrow in the Wizard of Oz after the flying monkeys have got a hold of me, you know, with just a bunch of, you know, shirt and, yeah, just laying there, you know, in the road with the straw all over the place. And it's nice in that movie where symbolically the mighty companions, you know, just say it's going to be okay, and they stuff straw back in the sleeves and everything, and, you know, it's going to work out. But the terror is this fear of loss. So it does take a lot of practice, you know. It's, you can use the word purpose, get into your purpose, get into your calling, get into your function. But really, most people, when they start to go into this, you know, function, calling, purpose, what's that? Like, oh, you're not telling me I'm going to have to be like a rabbi or something like that. No, but it's this emptying out and letting it kind of infuse you or come through you, and you know, tapping into that flow and that current. You know, seems to be take a bit of practice. So there's the gap between the letting go and this purpose seeming to kick in. And that gap can be quite a frightening, disillusioning, disorienting, you know, gap.
In this relationship, it feels like it's much more infused with emotion and fire and feelings, just raw feelings and threat. And it seems to wreak havoc and destruction. So if I can let it go, is it worthwhile to let it go? Or is there some value in it?
Well, it's the attraction to guilt, but it's like we talk about how when you're wound into something, you get unwound from it. But it's, you know, whether we talk about sexuality, or for some it's body image, and for others it's issues around food, or particular cultures, climate, you know, so forth. It's like an addiction to preferences, and then every topic you talk about has that same preference underneath it that is being loosened into the ego. It feels like it's an attack. It's like it's a loss of something that was had, or that was valued, or that was possessed, and now is being taken away. And so it's progressively, over time, you might say, the Holy Spirit brings you deeper and deeper into purpose, and washes the mind of the sense of need, of the sense of lack, the sense of grasping, trying to get something. You know, it just washes away as you go deeper with it. It also seems like a loss of control. The whole spiritual journey just seems like you're losing control as you go further with it, as if you had control in the first place and now it's being taken away. And so in one sense it's like the emotions have to come up and there has to be that intensity, and otherwise the mind will just go back and forth between seemingly wanting things, craving things, versus being repulsed, feeling never again, you know, just wanting to wipe your hands clean of something and so forth, and just kind of swinging back and forth and back and forth. And so, you know, that's what you're in for in the sense with the journey. It feels like, you know, it's about communication. So on one hand, when the intensity is there and it just seems unmanageable or too raw or too intense, the one option seems to be just no more of this, just, you know, get rid of the partner, just end the thing. And then the ego will come in really hard with that one, and then it will come back around with this other voice, which is like, oh, you need not part entirely. Still make this work. You just retain areas of fantasy, retain areas of privacy, you know, compromise. And so, you know, either there's this intensity, which seems to be a hatred and a repulsion that comes in, or the much more subtle compromise, you know, it's like, okay, I'm not even going to bring that topic up, because every time we do, then that happens. So I'm just going to keep it hidden. I'm just going to have certain aspects of my life and of my mind which I will not expose. And that's, again, part of the human condition of having secrets, things that are kept private, hidden, and guarded, quite guarded, because it's like, it's a feeling like it's too charged, like, they come up, it will just rock the boat and will crack the relationship open. So hence a lot of compromise can seem to come in, and that can take the form we call it, like, people pleasing. Yeah, there's a part in the Course when he's talking about the special relationship and handing it over to the Holy Spirit, giving the relationship over, inviting the Holy Spirit in. And he said, and what comes after that is that, you know, those that have done this are appalled. I think he uses the word appalled. You know, this giving over a relationship to the Holy Spirit or inviting in the Holy Spirit is just absolutely appalling what seems to come after that, because the Holy Spirit accepts the invitation and the purpose for the relationship has just been shifted. And the form of the relationship does not fit the new goal. I mean, the shift of the purpose is so strong that it just seems to be totally appalling. So I think that you're going through a bit of that. You know, you're starting to really call upon in your heart a sense of true, deep peace, of a sense of holiness even, and everything unlike the peace and everything unlike the holiness is kind of like a reaction or a revulsion to this call for the peace and the holiness. It seemed to be easier to just go through and compromise or hide and just pick your spots, but it just seems like it feels almost unmanageable, like, oh my gosh, if I'm really going to start exposing and not holding on to areas of fantasy and privateness and separateness, it just seems like it's so full on. And that is what you seem to go through. I mean, I think everybody who goes on this journey faces a period where it just seems overwhelming, highly sensitized, you know, just you feel like you want to escape. Or I've heard people say, turn it back, turn it off, or get it back the way that it was. I don't know what I did, what I invited, what I called upon, but stop it. And then it starts to dawn this awareness that you can't really go back. There's nothing really to go back to.